Hello students, myself Siddheshwar B. Tuljapure, Associate Professor, Department of Mechanical Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. So today we are going to deal with the topic, it is Introduction to Flywheel. The learning outcome. At the end of this session, students will be able to explain the role of flywheel. The contents are, firstly, the definition of flywheel, then parts of flywheel, then the turning moment diagram which is associated with the flywheel, then variation of crank speed due to the variation in torque, then examples of flywheel application, then we'll shift to the difference between flywheel and governor, and then material of flywheel, lastly, the references which we have used for this session. Let us see the definition of the flywheel. A flywheel is a heavy wheel which serves as a reservoir, storing energy during the period when the supply of energy is more than the requirement, and releases it during the period when the requirement of energy is more than the supply. By the definition itself, you can observe that we are in the requirement of a reservoir, and the reservoir is required because we are going to have the variation in the supply and the demand. The demand, if it is more, then, and if the supply is lesser, we should have one more source. It is then, if the demand is lesser and supply is more, we should have the storage of that one. So flywheel serves as a, say, reservoir, storing the energy whenever the excess it is in available, and then it is releasing it whenever we are in need of that one. The different parts of the flywheel we will observe. Flywheel, basically, it is a wheel which is heavier, and next to that one, as it is a wheel, it is circular. Then you can observe the different say parts of it. Firstly, at the center of the wheel we are going to have the hole. So this hole, it is needed because the flywheel, it is to be fitted on the crankshaft, and then surrounding this hole we are going to have this part which is called as hub, and then the outermost part of the wheel, flywheel, you can observe, so it is called as rim. Then the hub and the rim, these are connected to each other with the help of the arms, or these are also called as spokes. So now in this case four arms are there. So at the center it is hub, and hub is, it is having a hole, and on the outer side it is the rim. So you can observe the same here. So here it is the crankshaft on which the flywheel, it has been fitted, and then here the number of arms, these are more. So here it is four and here it is five, and then the outer rim portion you can observe. Then the turning moment diagram, it is associated with the flywheel. So the turning moment diagram we have seen in detail in the first session. So here again, just we will have the revision of that one. So in case of the, say, internal combustion engines, or in case of the reciprocating steam engines, etc., we are not having the constant output torque with reference to the crank angle. That is, crank shaft, it is rotating about its own axis, and the angular, say, motion, it is taking place. If we are representing it in terms of the theta here, and the turning moment, it is represented on the y axis, the blue colored line, it is showing you that the torque, it is continuously varying. So in case of this, due to the power stroke, say, the energy will be available, and during the other strokes like suction, compression and exhaust, etc., the power will be consumed. So because of which we are going to have the variation in the torque. So the torque is not continuously produced by the these types of the engines. So as the power stroke, it is taking place, in case of this one, the speed of the crankshaft or the crank, it is going to increase. So we are going to have, corresponding to this one, the angular motion will be there. So angular speed or the angular velocity, it will be, say, omega max, it is given. So because it will be higher, and then next to that one, when the energy, or instead of say being produced by these types of engines during the other strokes like, say, suction, compression and then the exhaust, etc., so if the energy is consumed in those cases, we are going to have the reduction in the speed, and say the speed is reduced and it is going to have some another value which is say shown as omega minimum. So as the time passes, so you can see that the x-axis it is representing the time, and on the y-axis we are having the speed of rotation. So in case of this one, we are going to have the continuous variation in the speed in every cycle. So you can have one cycle from here to here, and then again the continuous repetition it is occurring, and number of cycles are there here, and in one cycle only you can consider from here to here also. So in case of this, there is variation in the speed, so increase and decrease in the speed it is going to occur, and the highest value of the omega we are going to have, that is called as omega max, and lowest value it is omega minimum. So like this, the crank speed it is continuously varying due to the variation in the torque, which is due to the intermittent power strokes and not the continuous power strokes. Now think of whether a flywheel is needed in case of a punching operation in a punching press, which is driven by an electric motor. See, in case of electric motor, there is no power stroke and say suction stroke, etc. So here electrical energy it is converted into the mechanical energy. But in case of this one also, we are in the requirement of a flywheel. See, the flywheel it is needed basically in two cases. One, when the load is constant and torque it is varying, the torque which is available it is varying, but the load is constant. Like say in case of the vehicles, if suppose the vehicle is carrying a constant load from one place to another place, the load it is going to be constant, and the torque which is provided by the engine of that vehicle it is varying continuously in a cycle. So in case of that one, say like say IC engines, etc., or you can think of also reciprocating steam engines, etc. So in those machines which are say using these types of the engines, we are going to have the use of flywheel. And then the secondly, we are going to have the say one more type where like say the machine is there which is now punching press, and in case of this one the electric motor has been used which is going to provide you the constant torque throughout the cycle. But when the ram it is coming from the top side to the bottom up to touching that sheet metal, so till then it will have very less load, and then during the punching operation it will have very high load, and then again the while the ram is moving vertically upwards to the original position, the again the load it is very less. Like that, in case of the punching press, what is happening is the torque is constant which is provided by the electric motor, but the load it is varying. So either of these two, that is either the load is varying or the torque which is used it is varying, so out of these two, if anyone is varying, we are in need of the flywheel to reduce the fluctuation in the speed. Examples of the flywheel applications. The flywheel applications, you can observe that say in case of the sewing machine also, so during the stitching only the say power required it will be more. So in sewing machine we are going to have this wheel say which is going to act as a flywheel. Then in case of the punching machine, just now we have discussed the flywheel is there. Then next to that one, in case of the two-wheelers also, we are in need of the flywheel. Two-wheelers because they are using internal combustion engines. Now let us see the difference between the flywheel and the governor. Governor also we are knowing. Flywheel reduces the fluctuation of the speed of the crankshaft during every revolution. That is, this fluctuation is mainly due to the non-availability of the power stroke continuously. So power stroke availability is intermittent, and during the other strokes like suction, compression, exhaust, etc., the energy will be utilized, and due to that one we are going to have the variation in the speed. So this variation, that is omega max and omega minimum, we have just seen. So if this difference between omega max and omega minimum, if it is to be reduced, then we have to make use of the flywheel. So flywheel basically reduces the fluctuation of speed. Even though we are making use of the flywheel, there will be fluctuation, but that will be lesser when as compared to when we are not using it. On the other hand, the governors, these are, say, keeping the speed of the crankshaft as constant. So in case of the, say, the turbines, etc., which are coupled to the electrical generators, so in case of that one, we are in need of the constant speed of the say generator shaft, because the electricity produced will be depend, the frequency of that one, it is dependent upon the shaft speed. So if the generator shaft, it is rotating at different speeds, the frequency with which the electricity is generated will vary. So there we require the speed of the generator shaft as constant one. So there we are going to have the governors to control the speed of the turbine shaft, which ultimately leads to the control of the speed of the generator shaft. Now in case of the materials of the flywheel, we are in need of the energy storage. So heavy materials are to be used. Hub and the spokes or the arms, these are contributing very less. So the lighter materials can be used for this. And the rim, that is the outer part, it is contributing very large, say up to 90%, etc. So because of which the high density material can be used. Hub and the spokes, these are leading to 10 to 15% of the contribution for the energy storage. So even though the flywheel it is to be heavier, the for efficient flywheel, the rim it is to be made for of high density material, and hub and the spokes, these should be made up of lighter material. These are the references which have been used for this session. Thank you.